I will be telling a story of a student named Dr. Chinmayanan. So this is a story which is different from other students who have just passed the FMG exam. So Dr. Chinmayanan scored 169 marks in his very first attempt. First of all, congratulations, Dr. Chinmayanan.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Pause. Let me be the narrator of my own story.
Studies have shown that all humans are not same everywhere. Who you are, how you are, is at least partially influenced by surrounding environment, which has an impact on you and your thinking process.
I'm so emotional.
Why, brother?
Because I'm going to leave this country soon.
कोई बात नहीं, सब ठीक हो जाएगा, सब ठीक हो जाएगा.
Including me, when I had decided to study general medicine from Russian university back then, and even though it seems very heroic by walking these 6 steps to receive this MD physician degree, which is equivalent to MBBS degree in India, but these few steps to become a doctor wasn't a cakewalk, because it took 6 years of pain, patience, parents' money, and my failures. A lot of failures, which have given me opportunities, and I have grabbed it.
Apart from that,
I have gone through a lot of negative words and judgmental mindsets. For example, Russian degree isn't valid. And if valid, then there is a screening test for FMGE, which is evolving beast and is among the really difficult exams, since only 10 to 20% students pass it.
Still, there are some opinions that there is a marked difference or a marked line between foreign medical graduate, that is FMGE, and Indian medical graduate, according to few opinions. I don't think so, because there is no such thing called as right or wrong, best or better. These are just perspectives. Same about the life. What is wrong, what is right, is kind of stereotyped by humans. It's not correct that you are not getting admission in India. It means that you are not eligible for anything in your life. I don't think so.
So better to wipe that line and make your own path. And that path was Russia for me, which played a huge role in my life in the form of Kazan State Medical University. Graduating from this university was reasonably priced with quality education. And of course, few things will differ because their curriculum is different, but credit goes to them also. And since they existed, that's why we are existing.
बच्चे 2 साल में कोटा से निकल जाते हैं, कोटा सालों तक बच्चों से नहीं निकलता.
सभी को अपने अपने घरों में टॉपर्स और रैंकर्स उगाने, हर किसी को अव्वल नंबर चाहिए. डॉक्टर, इंजीनियर, मैनेजमेंट, इससे कम तो बर्दाश्त ही नहीं.
इंजीनियर्स बड़े चालाक होते हैं सर, ऐसी कोई मशीन ही नहीं बनाई जो यहाँ का प्रेशर नाप सके. बनाते तो पता चल जाता कि ये सुसाइड नहीं, मर्डर है सर.
Another student died by suicide.
Student suicides have become a big problem.
कोटा में 24 घंटे के भीतर 2 और बच्चों ने.
Many non-student suicides were reported in Kota.
For how long can we let this happen?
Another student has tragically lost her life to exam stress.
2 students have committed suicide in Rajasthan.
How many more suicides would it take for the rat race to really end?
Quitting isn't an option, but Indian students are going through a rough patch of parents' expectations compared to exam stress, restlessness, and mental health issues, and I can relate to this. Whom to blame? Parents? Of course not. Express, speak up, and make them understand, because there is always a way out. Winning a battle of restlessness. Back then, when I took admission at Kazan State Medical University in 2017, my family's economic condition wasn't sound, and I had to take an education loan to come here, and this was a burden on me, which gave me restlessness of not letting my parents down, rather my dreams down. And due to this, my first 3 years at university were too hectic, being restless, lonely, exhausted, and I felt like a machine, and things got even worse.
The World Health Organization declared the coronavirus pandemic a global emergency. It's a war breaking out in the Arctic.
While going through this turmoil of emotions, I was questioning myself every day. Am I on the right path? Am I happy? Am I satisfied? And answer came an absolute no. When COVID and war situation was fading a little, I had decided and divided my priorities on a bar graph of 100%, like this: 50% studies, 25% my time, travel, weekends and workouts, 25% part-time work to enjoy my time. Along with this, I had decided to chase my dream of YouTube and traveling, which I had from the first year of university, but I couldn't start early due to lack of confidence. And I guess it's never late. By the end of 4th year, I took a first step, did part-time jobs, paid my bills, and booked my 2 yearly trips. This changed me, and I was feeling better. My approach toward difficult situations changed, and I felt the freedom of life. Moral of the story is that I am one of you, a bit impatient, bit confused, with a hell lot of ambitions and restlessness, and still figuring out life's equilibrium. And it's absolutely normal being like this. Let me tell you one more thing. While I was writing the script on train from St. Petersburg to Kazan, there was a rebellion in Moscow. So being FMG, especially from Russia, restlessness won't be going from your life for sure.
Remember, life is a race. अगर तेज नहीं भागोगे तो कोई तुम्हें कुचल के आगे निकल जाए।
15-15 घंटे पढ़ना होगा, सिर्फ 6 घंटे सोना होगा।
क्या बनेगा बड़ा होकर? कैसे बराबरी कर पाएगा इस दुनिया के साथ? क्या सारी उम्र में से घर पे बैठ के खिलाता रहूंगा?
Breaking the mirage of idealism. Neither I can read nor revise thousands of pages or two subjects in a day, but I can try to complete things in a chunk or parts with equal efforts so that my subconscious will be ready for answering new things too. This subconscious thing has helped me, and whatever I am is due to this, and I don't get burnouts. Why I am saying this? Because there is a wave of idealism and perfectionism on YouTube. So stop making medical YouTubers as your idols, and no one is ideal in this world. Don't follow someone's routine and don't be a blind follower. Rather, experiment and make your own routine by knowing your capabilities and by taking calculated risk to avoid unnecessary stress, depression and burnouts. I was studying on an average 6 hours a day, not much, not less. Still, I am sharing my vague routine as an example. My techniques were simple. For 6 years of med school, I used simple books by good Indian authors, for example, Pharmacology by Govind Rai Garg, and others are in this list. Apart from this, in 3rd and 4th year of my university, I had Marrow, an online platform which I use for clinical subjects mainly like surgery, medicine, obgyny, ENT and ophtha. Remaining things I did parallelly with university classes. Later I had just my handmade notes for clinical subjects and short subjects and basics I did from free YouTube videos by Cerebellum Academy and other free sources too. Why I didn't buy another subscription? The reason is that concepts never change, and concept is a key for any medical exam. Now, about last 6 months, I had divided my day in two parts, pre-lunch and post-lunch, with 30 minutes of workouts in between because I wanted myself to be active throughout day without a nap. A pre-lunch, I was doing main subjects. Post-lunch, I was switching for basic subjects like anatomy, physiology, biochem, or short subjects or FMT. So it was a balanced routine, I guess. Apart from this, I had given free grand test by all platforms where I was scoring in a range of 150s to 180s, and every time I was doing one-liners wrong, and same happened in main exam. And after exam, I was nervous with little bit of hope too, because I knew if this much hard work I have done, then of course I will get rewarded. And guess what? I survived. So focus on everything. And I would like to add, if you are aiming for 200 plus score in FMG, then go according to NEET PG strategy. Solve MCQ from all medical exams in India. That will help too. Because there is no ideal pattern for FMG exam, and don't rely totally on previous year questions. Because the recall shared by students is completely different from the main paper. It's filtered data. Prepare for the worst, so don't be a blind follower. You can unfollow me too if I am sounding weird.
The good aspect. So number one, tuition fees, which is very less here in Russia compared to Indian private medical colleges. The reason behind that is all the Russian universities are under public sector and owned by government. And number two, less tiring exams, because exams are most probably in the Viva format. The part of writing and assignment will be waived off, so that is a good one more good. Then number three, you can work on yourself. That is, you can pursue your hobbies other than studies and try to excel in that. You can build your personality because you will have a lot of time, because there are just two classes a day, one lecture in the morning and afternoon one class. Exceptions are there in second and third year, because these years are one of the busiest and were busiest in my university. It depends on university to university. Then number four, you can travel a lot and explore as much as you want. Personally speaking, traveling helped me a lot, because when I was in school, I was an introvert. But after coming here, I was like, I changed myself, and I'm still trying to change myself. The negative aspect. And number one, there are lots of distractions here at Russia because it's a very open culture and you can get distracted easily to anything. You will understand me what I'm saying. And number two, life is very slow here, since most of the months it's cold and winter, so you may get depressed and feel lazy about everything. So that's a negative aspect, and life will be very slow. Number three, that is, getting marks here at Russia is not a big deal. It happens sometimes that even if you have said correctly 100%, you may get 70 or kind of 80% marks, because it's all about teacher, how you satisfy them according to their knowledge. I will say, I'm not complaining and no grudges with anyone, but still, it's a reality. So even if you get 90s or all 5s in all subject or kind of good marks every time, doesn't make you the best student. And there is no term called as best student. You are always a learning student. Try to focus on it. You are on your own. And number four, there are a few subjects like clinical subjects like ENT and Opta. Here, according to their education system, they teach us like in 1 week, we have cycles of subject for one for probably 2 weeks or 1 week. And they will try to finish all course within 1 week or 2 week time span. Like for what they did with ENT and Opta. I don't know about other universities, but it was the same situation with my university. So try to complete those subjects according to your comfort, not according to what university says, but study their material also. It's important to pass their examination. So that's, I thought that was a little bit negative aspect, because you need time for those clinical subjects, but it's their education system. It will be kind of clinical case-based. So you have to study on your own, try to read original textbooks maximum time, till third year at least, till pathology, you should read textbooks. And then you can opt for the online platforms that you feel comfortable. Anyways, in all subjects, you have to study on your own. It's university, not college or not school.
Avoid fear of failure with Plan B. By making this statement, I am not promoting going abroad, and neither I am saying not to try for NEET UG. But look at this.
NEET UG 2024 registration surpassed 25 lakh mark.
It's your dream. Whatever you want to do, you can do and you have to do. And one more thing, you should have a plan B, because being from a middle class family, most of the time there are chances that your dreams would get crushed. Believe me, it's worth it.
And I am just requesting all medical aspirants or aspirants in any field to have plan B to avoid unnecessary heartbreak. So here is a conclusion. It was easy for me to get broken and spill the beans during my journey, but I kept going with a little bit of patience, stubbornness and positive attitude. If one more time I get a life, then I would love to live like this. Be normal, think, believe and make it happen.